أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، جاء بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا، وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى أصحابه وأتباعه ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى أثره إلى أن ترث ربنا الأرض ومن عليها. اللهم إنا أمسينا نشهدك ونشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك بأنك أنت الله وحدك لا شريك لك، وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. إن شاء الله for the few minutes we will be talking about very important command from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Very important manners, if we can say, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command each and every one of us to have it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Isra, as many of us know this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. After obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He command you to obey Him and to take His command seriously. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be nicely to your parents. Be nice to your parents. Respect them. Obey them as long as they are not telling you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another ayah, وَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا. In another ayah, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا. In many ayahs, in different ways, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you, even if they were a disbeliever, obey them. Listen to them. Be nicely to them. As long as they are not telling you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are not telling you to leave your religion. They are not telling you something out of your deen. Then listen to them. Then be nice to them. They don't have to be Muslim to listen to your parents. They don't have to be Muslim to be nice to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, even if they are kafir, you have to be nice to them. This is our deen. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said three times, khaba wa khasir, khaba wa khasir, khaba wa khasir. He is among the losers three times. So the companion said, who ya Rasulullah? قال من أدرك أبويه عند الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما ولم يدخلاه الجنة. Who's the loser, ya Rasulullah? He said, whoever reached his parents when they are alive, both of them or one of them, and he didn't go to the Jannah because of them. Because they are their way to heed the parents. Actually, this is the way to Jannah. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, the companion, when he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he said, ya Rasulullah, we all know this hadith. من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي. Ya Rasulullah, who is the most person I should be friendly to, ya Rasulullah? He said to him three times, أمك قال ثم من قال أمك قال ثم من قال أمك قال ثم من قال أبوك. Three times, your mother. And then after he said, your father. This is how our religion, not only that, our Islam and our religion counted disrespecting and disobeying our parents as a kabira, as a major sin. So disobeying our parents, disrespecting them is a kabira. This is how our Islam, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to respect them as much as you can. We know the people of the cave, when they went inside the cave, and then the cave, one of the big rocks closed the cave. One of them said what? They sat together and they start thinking what to do. How can they move this big rock? So everyone decided he will say the best of his deed and his life that he did. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might take this rock away from their ways. So everyone start mentioning his. One of them said, Allahumma inna kana li abawani shaykhani kabira. Oh Allah, I had two parents. So he used to go get the milk, come to his parents. He's saying this is his deed. So there are three of them, and one of them is saying this. I'm just bringing the one who's saying what happened with him. He's saying, "Oh Allah, I had two parents. I used to go and grab the milk for them, and then he would come at night. He would find them sleeping. He would find them asleep. So even his children wanted to drink. They wanted to eat. So he would stay with the milk standing beside them till they wake up in the morning, and then he give them the milk. Before even he feed his children, wait for his parents. He wouldn't wake them up. He would wait till they wake up by themselves, and he would give them the milk before even giving it to his children. This is how they were respecting their fathers and their mothers. I was reading in one of the sayings, I don't remember exactly which of the hadith was mentioned, but look how much mercy and how much rahmah and how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you a blessings. I remember we said this when our brother, his mother passed away, brother Adil, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her, last year. When the mother died, the angels call you and they will tell you, Yabna Adam, O son of Adam, Matat التي كنا نكرمك من أجلها فعمل صالحا نكرمك لأجلك. The one, look, subhanallah, O son of Adam, the one we used to give you blessings because of her, she died. So now you have to work hard for yourself to get your own blessings. No more blessings, خلاص. It's done. Free blessings is gone. You need blessings, you want blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you have to work hard for this. Look how much of us have shortened towards their parents. How many of us, if their parents are alive, they would pick up the phone every day or every single day and they would call them and see how they're doing. We all, yani most of us, illa ma rahima rabbi, we always prefer our wives, our husband, our children more than our parents. And Allah didn't want that from you. We all do that. We buy the best things to our wives. We give nice gifts to our husband. We bring all the nice stuff for our children. And what is left, we give it to our parents. Bismillah. This is a small gift for you here for the year. How many of us would pick up the phone and call them and they see what they need? How many of us would go there and say, you are my way to Jannah. I am here to serve you. I'm here to see what you need. Few of us do that nowadays. We only care about ourselves. We only care about our wives, our husband, our children. But the parents come at the end. It's okay. They are, alhamdulillah, they are fine. They're sitting there. How many of us, if their parents are not alive, how many of us would do a good deed for them? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam counted one of the things they could, or two even, you could do two of those things. Sadaqatun jariyah. How many of us start off every Ramadan or every once in a year, two times in a year, they will do a continuously sadaqah for the parents. Put their money in a masjid, in an orphan place. They would have any type of good deeds. They will do it in the intention of their parents. How many of us would do that? How many of us, as Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, if you want to be among the righteous, if you think you are a righteous, or if you think you are the good son for your parents, are you making dua for them? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said what? إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث صدقة جارية أو علم ينتفع به أو ولد صالح يدعو له. A righteous son or a children, they are making dua for them. Wallahi brothers, we all, we make dua for ourselves and we don't make dua for our parents. Look how much they suffered. Al-Imam Al-Hassan ibn Ali, he would eat with his mother. He wouldn't eat with his mother, sorry. He would sit with his parents, but he wouldn't eat. So when they asked him, why are you doing this? He said, I'm scared if my hand touched any of the food that she wanted and I took it before she eat, before she wanted it herself, for herself. So he's worried to eat with them because he doesn't want to eat and actually she wanted that food and he might eat it. So he said, no, I don't eat with them. One of the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his mother called him and he said, Labbaik, Labbaik ya Ummah, and labbaik. Is yani is we say labbaik when we go to Hajj. This is the most respect word you can use with your parents. Like na'am, yes, this is the most respect word that we use with them. So he said labbaik ya umma. She might be was farther than him, or he might be didn't mean it. So when he said it, he felt that he said it loudly, louder than his mother's voice. So he went at the time of the Rasulullah. We know there was slave. He went and he bought two slaves and he freed them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just because he said labbaik and he thought his voice was a little bit louder. Look at ourselves nowadays. We argue with our parents. We don't listen to them. We don't respect them. And we want Allah to give us blessings. For what? We want to have blessings for what? Brothers, يعني, as the Salihin said, birru aba'akum, be nice to your parents, respect them, obey them, then your children will do the same. You don't want to disobey your parents and be rude or mean to them, and then we want our children to be nice with us. Doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Whatever you do with your parents, this is whatever you get. Whatever you plant, this is what you get, brothers. We have to think about it seriously. We have to think when it comes, especially in this blessings month, we have to think how to please our parents if they are alive. And we still can please them even with our dead. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that. To give a sadaqah for their behalf. Or even to ask about them, their friends. If they have a friends and they're still alive, go and ask about them. See their needs. See what they want. If they need anything, help them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And I will end with that inshallah. When he was standing, look how much Rasulullah, his parents died, his father died before he was born, and his mother died when he was young. Child. But still, look how much Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is carrying the favor. Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha, she did so much for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She is the most, and she was the closest one to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because she started, when he started the message, she is the most one supported him. The first one supported him. When he ran from Angel Jibreel, and she told him, don't worry, Allah will never let you down. Rasulullah, when his wife Khadija radiallahu anha died, she was older than him. She was 40, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, almost 15, 16 years younger than her. So when she died, Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, she saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam standing with an old lady, old woman standing with her. So she got jealous. She said, Ya Rasulullah, who's this old woman? Who's this woman? She said, this is the friend of Khadija. This is the friend of Khadija. She said, Ya Rasulullah, you still remember this old woman? And Allah has given you better than her? She's pointing at herself. And she's saying, you still remember this old woman? Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha. Do you still remember that woman and Allah has given you better? Allah has given you gift better than her? He said, Wallahi ma razaqani Allahu khayran min. Allah never gave me better than her. She is the one when the people told me you are a liar, she is the first one she believed on me. When everyone were harming, she were very nice to him. She is the one supported him with every single thing she had. This is how Rasulullah ﷺ carried the favor for his wife. The favor for his wife. How much we have favor to our parents and we are not paying them back. Some of our parents, alhamdulillah, they are not need of our money. They are not need of your financials. They are not, but they are need of your dua. They are need of your phone, calling them and asking about them. They are need to respect them. How many of us, if their parents are still alive? Wallahi, brother, we have so much shortened towards our parents. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us in the day of judgment. We will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He will ask you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a dua on you because we are not taking care of your parents. Rasulullah counted us as a loser because we are not taking care of our parents. 3 times. And when Rasulullah makes a dua, khaba wa khasir, this is actually a dua. And when Rasulullah makes a dua on someone, it's accepted. It's not like us, we raise our hands 10 times, 20 times, whole Ramadan, Allah's not accepting our du'as. Because things we might have here and there. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be careful when he make a dua on anyone that because he disrespecting or disobeying his parents, that's it. Khaba wa khasir, he's a loser. He's a loser. And the angels would say right away, Ameen. The angels are there always for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have to be very careful. We have to sit with ourselves and see how much shortened we have towards our parents. If they are alive, we call them, we take care of them, we visit them. If your manager at work tell you you have to go to this place, you have to go to that, you will run away going there. You want some extra bonus, or you want at the end of the month, say, oh mashallah, you're a very good man, I'm going to give you this and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you much more than that. What are you carrying for them? What are we having for them? So if you have a parents, go back and make sure always to please them. Always to please them. The companion, the only thing the companion would get upset on the followers of Rasulullah, the righteous people, when they tell them to leave their religion. Rather than this, they are sitting down there, looking what they want, and they do it right away for them. So please, in this blessing month, brothers and sisters, we need to review, we need to sit ourselves and think how much we have shortened towards our parents, and try to fill those shorten and try to fill those gaps. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might give you the blessings of this month, and He might as well give you the rahmah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a child who will respect you. If you respect your parents and you see your child like that, so know this is the fruit from what he planted. If you did it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you a child, he disobey you or he disrespect you, this is might be a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Nuh, he was a prophet, but his son was a disbeliever. It doesn't mean he wasn't good to his parents, but this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if we are mean to our parents, we don't care about them, we don't respect them, and we want our children to do that, we are totally thinking wrong. We are not getting kama tadinu tudan. We are not getting what we want. We have to think about it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and always make the dua, Rabbi ghfirli wa liwalidayya. Rabbi ghfirli wa liwalidayya wa lilmu'minina yawma yaqumul hisab. Or even the dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us in the Quran, Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. Oh Allah, shower them with your rahmah as they raised us. When we were small, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them if they are alive, and to shower them with His rahmah if they passed away. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wa'afina wa'afu anna. Allahumma arham walidayna kama rabbayana saghira. Allahumma arhamhuma kama rabbayana saghira. Allahumma zihima anna khayra al-jazai fi dunya wal-akhira. Allahumma zihima anna khayra al-jazai fi dunya wal-akhira. Allahumma zihima anna khayra al-jazai fi dunya wal-akhira. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.